And I want to let us know that if you look at figures at the moment of COVID cases in the country, Soroti is actually number two. If you look at cases right now, in terms of patients who are admitted, the first place which has the most patients is Mulago, followed by Nambole, which is all in Kampala. And outside Kampala, the highest place which has a lot of COVID cases is actually Soroti. Right now, we have about 70 patients admitted. But if you look at all the other regional referrals, the average is about 20 patients, 30 patients, 12 patients. But we have so many patients are admitted. And that shows how much support that we need to continue supporting people in our region. As I speak now, we have sent two vehicles, two ambulances out to pick patients who are very sick. We have a patient we picked from Bukedia, and patient who is 8 years old and his oxygen level is very low. We have four patients from Ngora who are also doing very badly, who need to be picked. We have just picked two patients from Manyara. So just today alone, before even 2 p.m., we have 8 patients who are actually coming into the facility who are very sick, requiring oxygen, requiring support. So the organization or the foundation called Emori Kikinos has actually come at the right time. I'm sure as we are here talking now, you're seeing an ambulance coming in with a patient who has COVID-19. So this support has come at the right time. And I'm sure as media, even as Emori Kikinos Foundation, I think you're seeing that you're putting your support in the right place. You're putting your support in a place that requires support. So words alone cannot be enough to explain how much we are thankful, and we pray that this continues. We also want to ask the other well-wishers, the other organization to continue supporting us to make sure that we save as many lives as we can. We know that we treat, but the Lord himself heals. But we try our best to make sure everybody that comes here walks back home alive.
Doctor, well aware that government recently rolled out the issue of home-based care. How many patients do we have here at Soroti under home-based care?
Yeah, so like I said, in terms of patients who are admitted, we are outside Kampala, we are number one, unfortunately. And that means that if you look at the way COVID is, out of every 10 patients who have COVID, two of them will be admitted, eight will be at home. So if you have 70 admitted, that means it can just show you how many more are actually in home-based care. So we have close to 190 patients who are right now getting treatment while at home in the... That's just in Soroti. If you look at the region in together, it's much higher than that. We have Serere having lots of cases right now, Ngora, Bukedia, Kalaki are having a lot of COVID patients. Most of them are getting treatment, you know, at home. And those who are sick are the ones we are admitting here. I also want to let us know that because of the very many cases of COVID, we had to open up another treatment center at Soroti School of Comprehensive Nursing, because our center here now was not enough to accommodate everyone. So we had to take some. So as I speak now, we have patients who are admitted at the School of Nursing. Just behind me, we have tents that we are putting ready for use. Hopefully by the end of next week, we'll be ready for use, so that we admit more patients in that tent. We have another tent the other side. We're also making it right to admit more patients, because there are very many people who are actually sick. Sadly, we have lost some people at home. We couldn't bring them here because we thought they were stable, and we kept them at home because the pressure in the ward was too much. But we have lost some of them at home simply because of lack of space. So if the tents become available, everyone who should be admitted will be admitted, and we hope that we can support them and make sure that they recover. So again, the Emori Kikinos team want to thank you again for the support. And where this money has come from, I pray that God replaces it with a hundredfold. And we pray that this organization, this foundation will grow. And also want to encourage other people to join. And I have from today, I'm already a member of Emori Kikinos Foundation. So I don't know what the membership fee is, but I'll also pay my membership fee today. Because we need to keep supporting. It may not be just COVID today. Tomorrow it will be hunger, another place. Tomorrow it will be another problem. We will come as a team of people in Teso to support our people.
Yes.
no one is going to support us, but we have to support ourselves to make sure that we get better. I want to remind us, I was impressed that Mbarara Regional Referral Hospital has built a new state-of-the-art COVID-19 treatment center. It was opened just about a week or so ago. And one of the things that we learned, some of the money came from local support from the people in that region. So we can also come together and support our people. This is a good starting point so that we keep solving problems in our region. So thank you very, very much.
Doctor, maybe of the 70 patients who are admitted here, how many are on oxygen?
So about half, 35 to 40 of them are actually on oxygen. But all the ones we are picking up today are all require oxygen therapy.
All right, Dr. Tolu, just a little advice and encouragement to the people out there, to the viewers out there as a doctor on the focal point of COVID-19.
Yeah, so as far as COVID is concerned, the numbers have actually gone down. They're not as bad as they were 2 weeks ago. So I want to encourage us, let us continue following SOPs. Let's continue making sure that we put on our masks. Let's not associate as much as possible. Let's make sure that when the vaccine comes, take up your vaccine so that we continue to fight COVID in our region. The hope is there. We can see some light coming. The cases have gone down. But it's not time for us to relax. It's time for us even to fight more so that we continue to fight hard and make sure that we fight COVID. It's sad. It's unfortunate that as a treatment center, as a region, we have lost some patients to COVID-19. It's painful. It's sad. But again, we know we treat and God heals. But our mandate, our pledge is that we shall continue supporting people and as much as we can. And our vow is that everybody that comes here should go back alive. So let's continue working together. Let's work together. Let's support each other. If you see that I'm going astray in terms of the fight against COVID, put someone online. Someone is wearing a mask. Make sure, remind them, put on their mask so that we all fight COVID together as a region. If there's someone in your neighborhood who is very sick, let us know. Support that person. Let's not stigmatize people who have COVID-19. Let's not shun them. These are our people. Any of us can get COVID today, so let's not stigmatize them, let's not discriminate against them, but let's rather support them so that we fight COVID in our region.
Thank you so very much, Dr. Tolu. And just something brief there.
Recently, the number of frontline workers who are being affected by the disease has been increasing.
So it's actually sad that, yes, some health workers have got COVID. What is more painful is that health workers have actually died of COVID-19. Especially, painfully, doctors. Doctors have died. We are a bit lucky that no health worker in the region has passed on, but we have health workers who have gotten COVID-19. Not just here, but also in the near districts of Teso. Many of them are getting sick, but we are lucky for now, no one has actually passed on. We had one who was very sick on oxygen. We were lucky that we were able to save her. So that is how it is, but we continue supporting each other. And we keep telling health workers that your safety is the most important. You cannot save another life if you're also sick. So we encourage them to keep protecting themselves so that they're able to save another life when they're healthy.